Very good morning to all the students. I am Dr. Prema, working as Associate Professor in Electrical Department, BMS College of Engineering, Bangalore. Today, I am here to take you through the third module of the course, Electrical Power Quality, with a course code 18EE825. And the module 3 of this course deals with fundamentals of harmonics. So let me first give a glance of the syllabus of module 3. It is having the following topics. We will be going through harmonic distortion and voltage and current distortions, then the difference between harmonics and transients, then the term harmonic index, then harmonic sources from commercial loads, harmonic sources from industrial loads, and the effect of harmonic distortion and in the harmonics. So these are the topics which we are going to cover in the third module. We'll be having around 7 to 8 lectures in this module. So today I'm going to have the first lecture in which I'm going to take you through the fundamentals of harmonics. So what does mean by the term harmonics? In the module 1, Umarao ma'am would have discussed a little bit of the introduction of harmonics. She would have told you that harmonics is the digital or integer multiples of the fundamental frequency. So we all know that the power system voltage has a frequency of 50 hertz in India. Now, the word harmonic means the integer multiples of the fundamental frequency, 50 hertz. So if you have a frequency of 100 hertz for the waveform, we call it the second harmonic, then 150 hertz for the third harmonic, etc. So basically, harmonic is a distortion of the fundamental sinusoidal waveform. So what is this, and why should we have these other components of the frequencies in the waveform? That is a question. The word harmonics surfaced as a buzzword in the early 1980s, making many people reconsider the effectiveness of their wiring system. Up to 1980, all loads were linear. That is, if the voltage input to a piece of equipment is a sine wave, the resultant current waveform generated by the load is also a sine wave. So such loads are known as linear loads. So what happened up to 1980, almost all the loads were linear. But after 1980, with the invention of power electronic converters and switch mode power supplies, the issue of harmonic emerged. Utility engineers were quite concerned about permitting these devices into power systems. The engineers were actually facing an unfamiliar phenomena that requires unfamiliar tools to analyze and unfamiliar equipment to solve. This was a major issue in the power system. The main issue with the harmonic problem is that the end user sector suffers more than the utility sector. Industry users with the loads like adjustable speed drives, arc furnaces, induction furnace, etc. are susceptible to harmonics. We can say that harmonic is an overshoot of power electronics. And why is this an overshoot of power electronics? What is wrong with power electronics? There is nothing wrong with power electronics, but we all know that in power electronics, we have power electronic switches which are on and off for controlling the voltage. You would have studied the course power electronics in detail. So we have mini circuits like rectifiers. We have AC to DC converters, which are called rectifiers. We have AC to AC controllers or AC voltage controllers. We have inverters, which converts DC to DC. And we have DC to DC converters like choppers. So all these power electronic converters have switches, and we are turning on and off the switch. And we know that by doing that, by for controlling the voltage, we are making the waveform slightly different from the sine wave, right? Suppose if you take the example of a rectifier, you can see that this is a rectifier circuit. And here in the first waveform, you can see that you have a sine wave, and which is shown in blue color. And then you have the yellow waveform, which is the output waveform. So yellow waveform, which is the output waveform. And here you can say that your output waveform, a waveform is an undistorted DC because of the capacitor. So the capacitor is charging and discharging. Because of that, you have an undistorted or almost smooth DC output. And the below the second waveform, which is showing the input current, you can see that the input current is not at all a sine wave because your output waveform is DC and the capacitor is charging and discharging every cycle. You have an output waveform DC, but the input current is not a DC. So what is the problem with this? When you have an undistorted waveform like this, this is not a pure sine wave and you have several components of frequencies in that sine wave, and such frequencies are called harmonics. So if I'm taking any waveform, so in the first waveform, you can see the red colored waveform, which is not a sine wave, right? That is a actual input or the voltage what we are taking into consideration. In the first waveform, the red colored one, which is called a distorted waveform. Even though it is distorted, you can see that there is a pattern in this waveform, right? So we can say that this waveform is a periodic waveform, but it is not a sinusoidal waveform, but because there is a pattern in it, it is called as a periodic waveform. Now, any periodic waveform with a particular pattern can be decomposed into several sine waves. As you can see in the waveform, you have a green waveform, which is a sine wave. And then you have an yellow waveform, which is another sine wave. And you have a blue waveform, which is also a sine wave. Now, even though all these are sine waves, we can see from the waveform that they are of different frequencies, right? You can say that the first waveform, that's the green waveform, which is the first harmonic. That means it will have the fundamental frequency of the sine wave, which is called the first harmonic or the fundamental waveform. And then the third harmonic will be the blue one, which is three times the fundamental voltage. Suppose if the fundamental frequency is 50 hertz, the blue waveform will have a frequency of 150 hertz and the yellow waveform will have a frequency of, this is the fifth, so it will be 250 hertz. Okay, so these are basically called the harmonic components in the waveform. Now, if you come to the second waveform in the figure, which is a square wave, all of you can see that you have a red color square wave. If you have a square wave like this, suppose if you have an inverter in your circuit, you will get a quasi square wave, right? Depending upon what PWM or what control technique we use, but we can have a square wave with an inverter. If you have a square wave, then we know that we can have several or infinite number of sine waves in it. So we have a fundamental waveform. See, have a note of this, that you have a square wave and you see the blue waveform in the second figure, which is a fundamental sine wave component of the square wave. And you can see that the peak of this is higher than the actual waveform. So this, we will be discussing about this little later. Please have a note of this, that you have a square wave, but when you take the fundamental component of the square wave, it has a peak of, which is higher than the actual input voltage. Okay, voltage or current, whatever. Now you can see the green waveform, which is the third harmonic, and you have a yellow waveform, which is the fifth harmonic. So these are called the harmonic components. And how do we obtain this harmonic components? We obtain this by taking the Fourier series of the input waveform, right? Why Fourier series? Because this waveform is a periodic waveform. Make sure that you are having a periodic waveform. Only then we can take a Fourier series of it. And most of the power system voltages and currents, even though they are distorted, they are going to be periodic. That's why we are concentrating on the Fourier series of it. So when you take the Fourier series of a non-sinusoidal periodic waveform, you get many frequency components in it. They are called harmonics. Now, you may be wondering why I'm taking, let us go back. You may be wondering why I'm taking only the odd harmonic. See, in both the figures, I have drawn only the third harmonic, fundamental, third and fifth harmonic. I can have higher frequency components also. But why only odd harmonics? Yeah, there is a reason for that. And see, in both the waveforms, the basic signal or the input signal, even though they are non-sinusoidal, they are periodic, and the x-axis and or the positive part and the negative part are symmetrical, right? See, in the first waveform, the red waveform, which is a non-sinusoidal wave, you can see that the positive part is symmetrical to the negative part along the x-axis. Similarly, in the square wave also, you have an equal positive and negative half cycles. So in such waveforms, when you take the Fourier series of such waveforms, you can see that all even harmonic components get cancelled. Or if you evaluate the even harmonics, they become zero. Right? So in most of the power system applications, we have the waveforms which are symmetrical with respect to the x-axis. So in such cases, we don't have a even harmonic. So we take care of only the even harmonic components. Now let us see why we have this harmonic coming into picture. Look at the figure here. We have a power plant. It can be any power plant which we have. Now we all know that the electricity is produced in power plant, which are of pure sinusoidal in nature. So we are producing a sine wave. Now, if you are having a power system, the transmission system or distribution system, we have taken the equivalent diagram of the power system. So here you may have the line components, which are inductors and resistors. They will be linear in nature. So if you are passing the output voltage or the sinusoidal voltage through a linear load, then you will have a current which is shown in the red color. So what is the blue color is a voltage and red color is the current waveform. Now what is the difference between these two? You will have only a phase lag, or you can say that the current will lag the voltage when you apply to a linear load. Now in case if you are having different, you may have different type of loads, right? At your end user side, you can either have a light load, which is shown here as a lamp, or any other linear load. Suppose if you are having a linear load, you will have the current also as a sine wave, just like your voltage. So voltage is a sine wave which is produced from the power system. But if you are applying to a linear load, the current also is going to be a sinusoidal, slightly lagging or leading, depending upon what type of load you have. But in case of nonlinear loads, most of the nonlinear loads are having some power converter in it, right? So either you have a fluorescent lamp, or you have a power converter to it, or even if you have an arc furnace or an induction furnace, the load is known to be nonlinear. As I told, when you say nonlinear load, you can say that the current is not proportional to the voltage. Such loads are called nonlinear loads. Okay. So if you are passing your current through a nonlinear load, your current may get distorted. Or when you say the current is distorted, you can say that there are some harmonic components in the current. So this is the difference between the current waveforms when you apply to a linear load or a nonlinear load. Now, so we almost we know that harmonics are produced because of the nonlinear loads in the power system. Now, what is the problem with having such other sinusoidal components, or what are the common effects of harmonics? We are going to see that. See, here you can see there is a waveform here. This is a typical load loss comparison of a transformer loading for a linear load and a nonlinear. So your distribution system will have transformers in it. How the transformers are loaded in the case of a linear load and a nonlinear load. You can see that the losses increases rapidly in the case of nonlinear loads. So what is the what are the effects of harmonics? Of course, there are a lot of bad effects because of the harmonics. You may have resonance in the circuit. So what happens if you have an RLC, so RLNC components in the power system, you may have a resonant. And if the resonant frequency matches with any of the harmonic frequencies, then you will have either series resonance or parallel resonant condition in the circuit. And due to that, the current or the voltage in the circuit can increase tremendously. Okay, so that is a problem of resonance. And then if you have circuit breakers in the circuit, there will be false tripping of circuit breakers, and the fuses may melt down because of the high current, and there will be failures in the capacitor banks in the power system. Then the PLC, if you have PLCs or any SCADA systems, the input output can change the state. You have loss of lighting bias. You have, if you have SCADA in your system, you will have some SCADA issues. Then if you have variable frequency drives, they may also have problems with the false triggering. Then you have skin effect on cables, welding problems, motor failure, transformer failure. All these are common effects of harmonics. We are going to deal with each of these problems in this unit. This is only a glimpse of the harmonics. So today, as an introduction, I'm going to take you through only the glimpse of the harmonics. What is harmonics? What are the common effects of it? And how are we going to deal with it? So this is the entire module 2, module 3, and module 4 of this course. So today we are only having a brief introduction about all those we are going to cover in these units. Okay. So this is a list of common effects of harmonics. So let us take one by one. What is the problem with distribution transformers due to harmonics? So as I told, that due to harmonics, you will have distortions. There are many components of sinusoidal current in it. So because of that, there will be an increased heat, right? You have harmonic currents, you have many components of currents. Due to that, there will be heating effect. So there is an increased heat from harmonic currents, which can cause the transformer to fail. So the figure shows the thermal analysis of the transformer. You can see that the transformer gets heated. The main reason for heating of transformer is the harmonic current in it. And because of that, and we all know that the losses in the transformer, specifically the core loss, the eddy current loss, and hysteresis loss, they are proportional to the frequency of the waveform, right? Frequency of the voltage and current in it. Now, when you have more than one frequency component in it, you will have an increased eddy current and hysteresis loss. Also, the copper losses will increase. So overall, the losses are increasing. In the previous slide, we have seen a comparison of losses of linear and nonlinear loads. In linear loads also, you will have losses, but they are of linear in nature. But whereas if you have nonlinear losses, because of the harmonics, because of the several frequency components in the harmonics, your losses are going to increase. Because in presence of harmonics, the core losses are not going to be a constant. Fine. Then some standards say that a 7 to 10 degree increase in heat in the transformer can halve the life of the insulation. So that is another problem with the transformer, the insulation failure. So if you have a slight rise in the temperature, that is from 7 to 10 degrees rise in the temperature of the transformer, then it can halve the life of the insulation. So that is, these are the problems which harmonics can cause in distribution transformers. Now let us see what will happen to the circuit breakers. So again, you have harmonics which can cause false tripping in the circuit breakers. Because of the harmonic currents, you will have false tripping. Why false tripping? You remember, we have seen one waveform, which is a square wave, and the fundamental frequency, the amplitude, was higher than the square wave amplitude, right? So when you have such cases, you may have, because of that higher fundamental frequency, you may have a false tripping of the circuit breakers. So that means you will have there are peak sensing circuits in the circuit breakers. So they often trip even though the RMS value of the waveform is lesser, and if you have a fundamental voltage which whose peak is higher than the normal amperage value, you will have a false tripping of the circuit breakers. So also the harmonic current peak values can many times higher than the sinusoidal waveform. So that we have seen already one example. So it is possible that harmonic current peak can be many times higher than the sinusoidal waveform. So this is leading to false tripping of circuit breakers. Now, what are the problems with insulation, the cables in the power system? So most oftenly, the cables will have insulation breakdown because of the harmonics. Again, the reason is heat. The added heat from the harmonic currents will cause the breakdown of insulators on the cables. Also, there is a skin effect. The skin effect problem is there already in the cables, but the effect of skin, due to the skin effect increases in the presence of harmonics. Why? Because higher frequencies of the harmonics can cause the electrons to flow forward the outer sides of the conductor. So what happens because of that? It will reduce the ability of the conductor to carry current. So the current carrying capacity of the cable is going to reduce because of the higher frequency components in the current. So this will reduce the actual capacity of the cable. So suppose if the cable is of 10 amperes, now due to the harmonics in it, this capacity can be reduced to 7 ampere or 8 ampere. So what is wrong with it? You cannot have higher currents than that. So this is a problem with the cable insulation failure due to harmonics. Now let us see what will happen to the motor. So motors, we have motors everywhere in all the type of loads. We have several motors. And what will happen to the motors in the presence of harmonics? We have high frequency voltage components. We have current components also, right? So all these, the high frequency voltage components in the motors produce additional hysteresis and eddy current. So same like transformer, you have the core losses, whereas where you have hysteresis and eddy current losses, and both these losses are proportional to the frequency, some multiple of frequency. We know that, right? So as the frequency components increases, as the frequency, there are many frequency components in the voltage waveform, the hysteresis and eddy current losses are going to increase in the motors. And these losses will obviously increase the operating temperature of the motor, and the motor gets heated up. So again, you can see the thermal analysis figure, where you can see that an increased heat. This increased heat is mainly because of the harmonics. Also, due to the harmonics, you will have torque pulsations in the motors. So these are the problems due to harmonics in motors. Now let us see what happens to the generators. Yes, generators also will have problem. You will have a voltage regulator to control the voltage in the generator. And because of the harmonics, so as we have seen that you have fundamental components, third harmonics, fifth harmonics. So each the frequencies are higher. Because of that, you have many zero crossings, right? It is not the actual zero crossing of the main waveform. Due to the harmonics, it will have multiple zero crossings of the current waveform, which will affect the timing of the voltage regulator, and this will cause shutting down of the generator. So what are the problems we have seen? We will have a quick recap. These are the problems of the effects of harmonics in the transformers. You have heating effects, you have increased losses in the transformer, and the temperature, increased temperature can cause, reduce the lifetime of the insulators in the transformer. So these are the main problems with transformers. Then we have the problem with the cables in the power system. We will have the increased skin effect in the cables. due to which the cables, the actual capacity, current capacity of the cable reduces. So that is the problem with cables. And then we come to motors. What are the problem with motors? Again, because of the harmonic components, you will have several, the heat in the motor increases, due to which the hysteresis and eddy current losses are increasing. And that is the main problem with motors. Then we come to generators. You will have many false zero crossings in the current waveform, which will give false indication to the voltage regulators, which will cause the generators to shut down. So because of all this, what happens to the power system? The overall business cost is increasing. So harmonic increases the business cost in the entire power system scenario. So what is the reason for that? We will have increased maintenance. So we will have excessive heat. Because of that, we will have the increased maintenance of all the components like transformers, cable, busing, etc. And then we will have interruption of production due to downtime. Also, we will have to replace the components very often due to the failures. And we will have reduced system capacity. So all these are going to increase the business cost in the power system, right? So we can say that almost all the business is affected by harmonics. But what are the guidelines for harmonics? There are guidelines. Now there are a lot of methods of mitigation. So I was telling that power electronics is a main cause of production of harmonics in power system. And surprisingly, the most of the effective harmonic mitigation is also due to power electronics. So we can say that most of the active filters which are used for mitigation of power electronics, sorry, mitigation of harmonics, which are also applications of power electronics. So it is like getting rid of a virus using an antivirus, right? So the problems due to power electronics are solved with power electronics. So we'll be seeing all this in this unit. So we will have a quick recap of what we have seen. So what did we see here in the introduction of power harmonics? So we saw what is the definition of harmonic. The basic definition of harmonic is the distortion in any sinusoidal waveform. And the distortion, because the waveform is distorted, we can decompose this waveform into several frequency components of sine wave. So that is the basic fundamental definition of harmonics. So we have also seen that most of the power system applications, the distortion will be periodic in nature. And in periodic waveforms, even though they are distorted, we see that most of the cases, you will have equal or symmetrical positive and negative half cycle. Because of that, most of the even harmonics are reduced. We will have only the odd harmonics in it. And we have seen that how the waveform looks. And we also saw what are the effects of harmonics in various components in the power system. So here we are going to finish the introduction of harmonics. Now, what are we going to deal in this unit? We are going to see what is the actual definition of harmonic distortion. How do we evaluate mathematically? And when we talk of harmonic distortion, we have both voltage distortion and current distortion, right? Now, what is voltage distortion and what is meant by current distortion? That we are going to see. Also, there is a confusion whether the harmonic distortion is same as transients. You have transients in the power system, right? So we are going to see what is the difference between the transients and the harmonics. And then we will be going through there are some terminologies which we use in the terms in harmonics, basically to measure the harmonics. So first we will see what are the effects of harmonics in the various factors of power. We have real power, active power, or active power or real power. We have apparent power and we have reactive power, right? So these are the three components of power. And then, so we are going to see how these powers are getting affected due to harmonics. That is the next topic. And after that, we will be seeing what are the terms which are used in harmonics to evaluate. So when we say harmonics, we should know what is the actual measure of harmonics and how much harmonics we have in the system, right? So we have some specific terms called the total harmonic distortion, THD, TDD, etc. So we are going to see what are these terms and how we can evaluate these terms in terms of harmonics. So that is the next topic which is to be covered. Then we will be seeing in detail. So here in the introduction, we have seen a common effect of harmonics in your power system components like transformers, cables, motors, and generators, right? So here we are going to see in detail what are the, how is the harmonic produced in the various type of loads, okay? And then how is it going to affect the commercial loads? How is it going to affect the residential loads? And in the residential loads, what are the different type of residential loads? And how they are going to get affected? I was telling you that there is a problem of resonance, right? So we are going to deal in detail. What is the effect of the series resonance? What is the effect of parallel resonance, etc. Okay. And then finally, we are going to see there are some other phenomena like here we are going to, in all this discussion, we have seen only the fundamental and the integer multiples of harmonics, right? So that is third harmonic, fifth harmonic, etc., seventh harmonic, etc. But there are some cases where you will have non-integer multiples of harmonics also. They are called interharmonics. So the last topic of this module is interharmonics. So there we are going to see what is the effect of non-integer multiple of harmonics in it. So this is a glimpse of the module 3. And in the next class, we are going to see harmonic distortion. We are going to see the differences of voltage current harmonic. And then we will be seeing some of the terminologies which are going to be used in harmonics. So that is all for the first lecture. Thank you for listening. We will meet again.